Now, I just wanted to get a bit of knowledge about, like, whenever you are trying to design a product or some feature of a product, so, like, how do you go with it? Like, are you more focused on a product-led growth or, like, focused on marketing-led growth and, like, marketing your product so to an extent that it gets the correct user base, or, like, majorly depending on that product and designing that product so well that users actually come to use it? Like, so, like, how do you figure out the balance, the correct balance between these two?
I think good question again. The thing is, both have to go hand in hand. You know, initially it has to be in a way where development is. So we have what we do as an organization is we have a product roadmap. So we lay out a product roadmap, and we have achieved, we're still a young company, so we're still sometimes trying to figure out. There are certain things we're still learning in terms of how a customer uses something in terms of customer behavior, even about a single, let's say, feature, for example. So we have a product roadmap, and every time somebody asks us for, let's say, a feature or an enhancement or anything like that, we always validate that with our product roadmap. And then we say, hey, you know, nice ask. This will be delivered in 3 months from now or 2 months from now. That way, we're not leaving behind the existing development or existing, let's say, a plan to go and immediately fix something that a new customer is asking. If a new customer says, I will only work with you guys if I have this as a part of the offering. Then we show them our product roadmap and say, hey, look, what you want is 3 months away from today, or 6 months away from today, let's say. It's very important to manage expectations along with the product strategy and product roadmap. Both have to work well and has to work well together. So I think expectation management, business development can't stop, neither can development keep evolving, as per the requirement. So I think that's something we've learned now out of trial and error. But I think this strategy has been very, very helpful in terms of effectively having both channels work in parallel.
Okay.